Hi, in this session we are going to see how we are going to calculate the wrap address in AXI protocol. Before we move on to see how to calculate the wrap address, we assume the viewer knows the following things. One is supposed to know what is cache memory. Secondly, what is a transaction in respect to verification environment and basics of AXI protocol, in the sense the basic signals like AW size, AW length, which are relevant to this session, and burst mode of addressing. So where exactly the wrap address is used? So when the processor wants to communicate, wants to access cache memory, accessing cache memory type, then the master has to generate addresses corresponding to wrap mode. According to AXI protocol, there are two restrictions or constraints, I can say. The first constraint is that start address must be aligned to the size of the transfer. What does it mean? Let's say, for example, we have a 32-bit white bus, in which you can send maximum 4 bytes of data in a transfer. So we can call this 4 byte aligned. So they have 4 byte aligned boundary. In order to know if a given address is aligned or unaligned, we need to do the following thing. Let's take an example like 0x1002 is start address. In decimal it is 4098. So we need to divide this address by, let's assume here in this case the AW size is 2. So it is, the size of the transfer is 4. And we need to check if it is perfectly divisible or not. If it is perfectly divisible, then it means the address is aligned. Else, it is unaligned address. And we will see in the following example where in one of the scenarios the address is unaligned and how do we generate the wrap address. The second restriction says that the burst length must be 2, 4, 8, 16, etc. So the burst length should be of any of these values. Let's move on to the calculating the wrap address. Let's take, there are three scenarios. Let's take the first scenario where the start address is 4 and AW length is 3. AW length is your bus length is 4. So how it tells how many bits are there in your bus. And AW size is 1, which represents 2 bytes size of the transfer. So 2 in each transfer. Since the address is aligned here, the start address is 4, it's perfectly divisible. So let's calculate the wrap boundary. The wrap boundary is int of start address in decimal 4 byte. Total number of bytes to be transferred. Total number of bytes can be calculated from AW length and AW size. So total number of bytes equal to, so AW length plus 1 will be a best one. I can say like burst length multiplied by the size of the transfer, which is nothing but 4 cross size of the transfer can be calculated by 2 power the AW size. So 2 power 1 is 2, which is equal to 8. So my total number of bytes to be transferred will be 8, since there are 4 bits and each bit we are sending 2 bytes. So 4 by 8 cross 8. So 4 by 8 is 1 by 2 is 0.5, and the int function would round up this 0.5 to 1. So 1 cross 8, that will be 8. So our graph boundary in hexadecimal 0 is 0. Let's calculate the star address after that. This is start point after the initial point. This will be round of the start address 4 by total number of bytes to be transferred that you already know. In this case 0.5 will be rounded down to 0, 0 cross 8 will be 0 x 0 0. So now let's see the addresses to be shaped by the master. Since we have known the wrap boundary and the starting point of the wrap, so let's see 0 x 0 4 is my first address, and then 0 x 0 6 is 2 bytes in each transfer, so 0x06 will be the next address. Next address will be 0x08, but actually, so it's the wrap boundary is 0x08, so it needs to wrap back to the starting point, that is 0x00. So it is wrapped here, and then again it will move on 0x08. Let's move on to the next scenario where the start address is 0x38 and burst length is 4 and size of the transfer is 4. So in this case the address is aligned, 38 is 56 in decimal, 56, right. It's perfectly divisible and the address is aligned, so wrap boundary start address in decimal by the total number of the total number of bytes to be transferred, that is 4 cross 4 is 16. So 56, 15 is 56 or 16 is 3.5, and it will be rounded up to 4. 4 cross 16, which is 64, which would be 0x40. This is the start address after wrap round of start address by the total number of bytes to be transferred. So in this case 3.5 would be rounded down to 3. 3 plus 16 would be 48. And 48. Next up is 0x. Now let's see, since we have calculated the required parameters, let's see the addresses to be issued. 0x3c. Next address is 40, which is wrap only, so it needs to wrap back to 30. The next address will be 34. So now let's move on to the third scenario, where the start address is 7. First length is 4, AW size is 4. In this case, the start address is 7, which is unaligned because 7 by 4 is not perfectly divisible. So let's calculate the aligned address. In decimal will be 7 by the size of the transport is 4 cross 4 7 by 4 is 1.5 which is 2 cross longer, so 2 cross 4 that is equal to 8. So 0x8 is the aligned address. The wrap boundary is equal to 8 of start address 7 by the number of bytes to be transferred. 4 cross 4 is 16 plus 16. Is 1 cross 16. 0 minus, so 1 cross 16, that is equal to 16, and which means that is 0x10. Let's calculate the start boundary, start address. So that will be round of 7 by 16. It will be 0x00. The sum by 16 will be rounded down. 0 cross 16 will be 0. So since we have the required parameters, let's see the addresses to be issued. This case will be 0x07, the first address, 0x08 will be the next address, and then 0x0c. The next address, and the next address would be 0x10, which is the wrap boundary, so it needs to go to the start address after wrap, which is 00. We have seen three scenarios how to generate wrap address. When we have aligned address, then we have unaligned address. Thank you.